Hi, hello. Welcome back to another session of geography. In the previous session, we started one important lesson from geography part, that is unit 3, climate, soil, natural vegetation and animals of Karnataka state. From this lesson, we discussed about the main part, that is climate. The meaning of climate, the meaning of monsoon, climatic seasons of Karnataka state and distribution of rainfall. These are all points we discussed in the previous session. In this class, we are going to learn another part from this lesson, that is soils of Karnataka state. In today's class, we are going to learn on these topics. Those are meaning of soil and types of soil. So children, let's start our class with the meaning of soil. What is soil? It means soil is a thin surface layer of the earth, is called soil. What do you mean surface? Surface in the sense upper layer. The overall meaning of soil is the thin surface layer of the earth is called soil, or upper layer of the earth is called soil. The formation of soil in Karnataka state is not equally distributed all over the state because some factors influence on soil. The factors are climate and rainfall. These two factors are influence on soils in Karnataka state. The next topic here, types of soil. So soils of Karnataka can be classified into four types. Those are red soil, black soil, laterite soil and coastal alluvial soil. Let us discuss about the first type of soil in Karnataka state, that is red soil. Red soil, this type of soil is obtained from weathering of a granite and gneiss. It contains iron oxide, hence it is in red color, and also it is rich in iron, lime and salt. It is light and very thin layer, but it has no strong fertile, it means lack of moisture. Fertile in the sense phalavattate. So red color, basically it is very thin and very light and very thin, so it is lack of soil moisture. It has no strong fertile. Basically for agriculture production, fertility of the soil is very needed. It's very main aspect. But red color has no strong fertile. This type of a soil we can see in the southern districts, in the south Karnataka. The districts are Bangalore, Ramnagar, Mandya, Chamrajnagar, Davangere, Chitradurga, Kolar, Hasan and etc. Even some crops can be grown in the red soil. For example, ragi, vegetables, fruits and etc. This is about red soil. Next, move on another type of soil, that is black soil. Black soil is obtained weathering of basalt rock. Black soil is also called black cotton soil. Why it is called black cotton soil? Because in question only there, the cotton, it means black soil is the best suitable for the cultivation of cotton, so that it is called black cotton soil. So black cotton, so basically here it is rich in aluminium, magnesium and oxide of iron, so that it is in black color, and also it has a strong moisture. It's very strong, fertile. But red soil, the lack of moisture and the lack of fertile, but black soil has strong moisture and a strong fertile. It's the best suitable for the cultivation. Red soil we can see in the South Karnataka. In the same way, a black soil we can see in the North Karnataka districts. The districts are Koppal, Bidar, Raichur, Kalburgi, Bijapur, Belagam, Haveri and other districts. Some crops can be grown in the black soil. The crops are sugarcane, paddy, jowar, cotton and chilies. These are the crops can be grown in the black soil. So children, this is about black soil. Next, another type of soil in Karnataka state, that is laterite soil. This kind of a soil we can see in where heavy rainfall recorded and highest temperature, there we can see laterite soil. Then where we can see laterite soil in Karnataka state? Of course, in the place of Malnad region and as well as coastal plain, there we can see laterite soil. Here lime and silicates, these are the two important minerals in the laterite soil. These two minerals are dissolved in the rainwater and settled down in the lower layer. It means lime and silicates, ivereddu kanijamshagala mele malaya neeru ಬಿತ್ತು ಅಂತಂದರೆ, ಅದರ ನೀರೇನಾದರೂ ಅದ ಮೇಲೆ ಬಿತ್ತು ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ಲಿ ಕರಗಿ ಹೋಗುತ್ತೆ. ಆ ಕರಗಿ ಹೋದಂಥ ಒಂದು ಅಂಶ ಎಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ಅದು ಸೆಟಲ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ? ಲೋಯರ್ ಲೇಯರಲ್ಲಿ, ಅಂದರೆ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ಲಿ ಕೆಳಗಡೆ ಹೋಗಿ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಇನ್ ದ ಸೇಮ್ ವೇ ಐರನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಅಲ್ಯೂಮಿನಿಯಂ, ದೀಸ್ ಟೂ ಮಿನರಲ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ದೇರ್ ಇನ್ ಲ್ಯಾಟ್ರೈಟ್ ಸಾಯಿಲ್. ಬಟ್ ಇದ್ರ ಮೇಲೆ ಮಳೆ ನೀರು ಬಿತ್ತು ಅಂತಂತಂದರೆ ಅವು ಅಪ್ಪರ್ ಲೇಯರಲ್ಲಿನೇ ಉಳ್ಕೊಂಡ್ಬಿಡುತ್ತೆ. ಅಂದರೆ ಸಿಲಿಕೇಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಲೈಮ್ ಇವೆರಡೂ ಕರಗಿ ಹೋಗುವಂಥ ಒಂದು ಅಂಶ ಆದರೆ, ಐರನ್ ಮತ್ತು ಅಲ್ಯೂಮಿನಿಯಮ್ ಇವೆರಡು ಕರಗಲಾದಂಥ ಒಂದು ಅಂಶ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ಬೋದು. ಅಂದರೆ ಇವೆರಡೂ ಐರನ್ ಮತ್ತು ಅಲ್ಯೂಮಿನಿಯಮ್ ಇವೆರಡು ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಉಳ್ಕೊಂಡ್ಬಿಡ್ತವೆ? ಅಪ್ಪರ್ ಲೇಯರಲ್ಲಿ ಉಳ್ಕೊಳ್ತವೆ. ದ ಲ್ಯಾಟ್ರೈಟ್ ಸಾಯಿಲ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ ಸಾಫ್ಟ್ ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ in the season of rainy season and dries up in the summer season. Later it becomes laterite soil. Some crops can be grow in the laterite soil. The crops are arecanut, coconut, tea, coffee, rubber, cashew and spicy items. These are the crops can be grow in the laterite soil. We can see in the, as I told you, in the Malnad region and as well as in the coastal plain. The districts are Uttar Kannada, Dakshina Kannada, Udupi, Chikmagalur, Shivamogga and Kodagu. This is about laterite soil. Next, another type of soil in Karnataka state, that is coastal alluvial soil. This kind of a soil we can see in the coastal region. Alluvial soil is completely formed by the alluvium, and basically alluvial soil is also composed by sea waves and rivers. Then where we can see this kind of a soil in Karnataka state? Here the word is there, coastal. So coastal alluvial soil we can see in the coastal districts. The districts are Udupi, Dakshina Kannada, and Uttar Kannada. Even some crops can be grow in the coastal alluvial soil. The crops are Arecanut, Coconut, Cashew and others. This is about coastal alluvial soil. So by this topic, today we completed our session. So remaining topic we will study in the next session of class. So children, thank you and have a great day.